Good morning students, today I am going to teach you how to solve some questions that are related to polynomials and its theorems, remainder theorem and factor theorem. Here are some questions that is related, from your exercise 2.1 and 2.2. All the questions of 2.1 and 2.2 is not related here because some questions are left for you to for your practice, and some questions are written here for me to solve and show you how to solve all the questions and how they are related to all the theorems that are written in polynomials and that are taught by me in the previous classes. So, student, the first question is, which of the following expressions are polynomial in one variable and which are not? This question says that there are two conditions. The first condition is the given expression should be polynomial, and the second condition is the given expressions should be one variable. So we will write the expressions here and consider on it, and I will define each the given expression is polynomial in one variable or not. So students, solution for the first question of the first question exercise 2.1 is 4x square minus 3x plus 7. Here, if it is a polynomial, then it satisfies the definition of the polynomial. So, the definition, according to definition of the polynomial, all the exponential values of the given variable should be non-negative integer. So, I will write here all the exponential value of the given expression. The all the exponential value of the given expression is 2, 1, and 0. So we can clearly see that the given exponential value of the given expression given indeterminate in the given expression is 2, 1, 0 and all are non-negative integer. So this is a polynomial. The first condition is satisfied by the given expression. So it is a polynomial. Now the second condition is should be in one variable. So when we see the expression, we can see that there is only one variable x is used in the given polynomial. So the given polynomial also satisfies the second conditions of the question. So the given polynomial is the given expression is a polynomial in one variable. The first question is solved. Now the second question is, that is named 3 in your book, 3 root 3 square root t plus t root 2. Here when we analyze the question, we can see that all the exponential value of the given indeterminate in the given expression is, the first exponential value is 1 by 2. Because root under t can be written in the value of in the form of 1 by 2. So the exponential value of square root t equal to t to the power 1 by 2. So the first exponential value is 1 by 2 and the second exponential value is 1. So the given exponential value is not integers. They all are positive, but not all are integers. So the given polynomial, the given expression is not a polynomial. The second question is also solved. Now we will talk about the second question. Write the second question of exercise 2.1. This is the second question of the first question of exercise 2.1. Now we will talk about the question number 2 of the exercise 2.1 and the question number 2 of 2. So write the coefficients of x square in each of the following. Solution. So to write the coefficients of the x square in each of the following, we have to consider the given expression. The given expression is 2 minus x square plus x cube. So we can see here the x square is here. So we will write x square separately, a minus x square. We can see that any determinant cannot be in negative. So why it is negative? Because of a number that is hidden, that is not showing here. That's why it is showing negative. So we can write minus x square in the form of minus 1 into x square. So it is the original form of x square, and minus 1 is hidden. So minus 1 is coefficient of x square, because the number that is multiplied with any number is called coefficient for that number. So minus 1 is multiplied with the x square. So minus 1 is coefficient of x square. So coefficient of x square is minus 1. This is the answer of the question. This question is solved. Now we will talk about the second question of the second question of exercise 2.1. The second question is named in your book as third question of question number 2. Pi by 2 into x square plus x, where the solution is pi by 2 x square plus x. Considering the given expression, we see that x square is multiplied with pi by 2. X is multiplied with pi by 2, or we know that the coefficient of a number is a number that is multiplied with that number. So pi by 2 is multiplied with x square. So the coefficient of x square will be pi by 2. So the coefficient of x square is pi by 2. It is a very easy question. Now we will talk about the third question of the question number 2 of exercise 2.1. The third question is named in your book as a question number 4 of question number 2, exercise 2.1. But here, this is the third question in order way. First, second, third. The third question is solution. The solution is root under 2x minus 1. Here, when we consider the given expression, there is no x square. So, we can add a x square as x 0 into x square. There is no changing. After adding a 0 into x square, there will be no change in the value of root under. So root under x is minus 1. So we can add any number in the form of 0 into x square. So we can see that the coefficient of x square is 0, because the coefficient is the number that is multiplied with that number. So 0 is multiplied with x square, so 0 will be coefficient of x square. So the coefficient of x square is 0. Now we will talk about the third question of your chapter exercise 2.1 of chapter 2. The third question is, give one example each of binomial of degree 35 and a polynomial of degree 100. The question is saying that give one example of any variable having degree 35 and the polynomial should be in the form of binomial. So the first example solution is, the first example binomial having degree 35. We can pick any example, it depends on us. We can pick any example, 2x35 minus 5. It is a binomial and the degree is 35. We can take another example, x35 minus 2. It is also example for. So, we have several examples. We have innumerable of examples having degree 35 and also it is a binomial. So, it is a binomial having only two terms and a degree either 35 is 2x35. 2 to the power 2x to the power 35. We can write here taking another variable as 2a 35 minus a. It is also binomial having degree 35. Now the second question is monomial of degree 100. So the second question again a monomial. Having degree 100, so you can take any example as a x to the power 100. It is a monomial having only one term. The next question can be 4x to the power 100. It is also one monomial minus 5x to the power 100. It is also an example for the given question, and we can write. 5b to the power 100, where b x is variable indeterminate for the given expression having degree 100, and it is also monomial because having only one term. So these are the all solutions for the given all questions in your textbook, and now I think you put all the method that can be used to solve the rest questions that is left for you in the exercise. So students, try all the question that is rest for you, and after that I will let you know. Now in the second session and second video, after that in the next video, I will teach you some and solve you some questions related to 2.2. Thank you very much.